alternating voltage applied across the resistor. Alternating voltage applied across the resistor. Now let us consider this is the resistance, right? This is the resistance. Now this is alternating source. Alternating source. Generally this is the battery, this is the resistance, this is called DC source. Now this is called, what do you say, AC source. Right, now the DC source, it is nothing but what? The cell is connected to the resistance. Now as the AC source is applied to the resistor, right? Now AC source is applied means AC EMF applied. Therefore AC EMF applied, right? What is the AC EMF applied? E is equals to E naught sin omega t plus phi, right? Applied EMF. Applied EMF E is equals to E naught sin omega t plus phi. Now whenever we apply the EMF, then there is a current. Then there is a current. Right? Now the current is represented by capital I. Then there is a current. That current is passing like this. What is the current passing? AC current is passing, right? Now AC current is passing. As the current is there from higher potential to lower potential, this is a higher potential point, there is a lower potential point. What to say? Between these two points, what to say? There is a potential difference. There is a potential difference. This is the potential difference. Therefore, the potential difference, the potential difference right across the resistance Now potential difference I want to calculate. According to Ohm's law, V is equals to, what to say, IR. V is equals to IR. Now I is equals to, what to say, V by R. Now I is equals to, I is equals to what is V? Potential difference. Whatever the potential difference is here, it is equivalent to the, what to say, EMF. That potential difference, whatever the potential difference is there, that is equivalent to the EMF, what to say, E by, right? What is the resistance? R. Now this is called, what to say, first equation. Now from the first equation, what is I? I is equals to, E is equals to, what to say, E by R, that equals to, what is the E value? E naught sin omega t plus pi by R. Therefore I is equals to E naught by R into, what to say, sin omega t plus pi. Now this is called expression for EMF. Now this is called expression for current. Right? Instantaneous EMF, instantaneous current. Now here in this case, I is equals to. This term is known as what to say I naught into what to say sine omega t plus phi. Where I naught is equals to what to say E naught by R. Now this is called what to say maximum current, maximum EMF by R. In order to get maximum current, maximum EMF by resistance. Thereby, what is the final expression here? I is equals to I naught sine omega t plus pi. E is equals to E naught sine omega t plus pi. Right? By observing these two equations, what are the two equations? E is equals to, that is E naught sine omega t plus pi. What is the current expression? Whenever EMF, AC EMF is passed through the resistance, I is equals to what to say, I naught sine omega t plus pi. Therefore, this is the EMF expression, this is the current expression. That means, here what is the phase of the EMF? Omega t plus pi. What is the phase of the current? Omega t plus pi. That means they are under same phase. As they are under same phase, what is the EMF? This is EMF. What is the EMF? This is EMF. And the time. Right? EMF involves sine function. EMF involves sine function. This is the EMF variation. This is the EMF variation. Now, what is the current variation? The current variation is like this. The current variation is like this. Right? The current variation is like this. That is, in what way the EMF is changing? In the same way, that is, the current is going to be changed. Therefore, right, when the resistor is connected to, right, AC source, when the resistor is connected to the AC source, EMF and the current both are under same phase. EMF and the current both are under same phase. Both are under same phase. Right? Now, whenever AC EMF is applied to the resistor, then this is the AC current expression. Therefore, E is equals to E naught sine omega t plus pi. Next, I is equals to I naught sine omega t plus pi. Therefore, from this, the both are under same phase.